Well, I have something to talk about today. This is the Sharp SPC-476 alarm clock. Now, this alarm clock makes some interesting claims, and it is basically dirt cheap. And the claims say that it is automatic time setting, inferring that this is atomic or radio controlled. However, when I brought it home, I learned some things are not what they seem, and Sharp is a big liar. Now, when I plugged it in, the first thing I noticed is that the time set almost immediately. And by immediately, I mean within just 3 seconds, it had the time on the display. Anyone who's had an atomic radio controlled clock knows that they take a minute or two and sometimes multiple attempts to even get the time. And yet this one got it that fast? And not to mention, compared to a authentic radio-controlled watch, it was off quite a bit. So what's going on here? What is Sharp trying to pull? And what are the three problems that this alarm clock has that make it maybe not so much worth it, but with a simple modification, it becomes more usable. In fact, pleasing. Let's get into business here. So, curious about the claims that it's automatic, I took the clock apart to look for the radio module and to see what kind of module it's using. When I took it apart, I noticed something very fishy. There's no module in this. There's no antenna, no radio whatsoever, nothing. In fact, it was a coin cell battery. So in other words, Sharp's claim on the box saying, automatically sets the time, is nothing more than mumbo jumbo marketing speak, because alarm clocks since the 80s have had battery sockets and they hold the time when the power is out just fine. That's all this does. So what's going on there? Well, like I said, just mumbo jumbo. Now let's go on to the second point, which is not so much as a big deal. It's something you can live with. Sometimes like your watches, you have to reset the time after so many months because they drift just a little bit. This does not timekeep like most alarm clocks. Most alarm clocks use your mains frequency, that's 60 hertz or 50 hertz, as its time reference because that is a reliable time source. And I can guarantee you that power grid is very accurate on that frequency, and they know it. And to save money, they will put in those clocks the ability to use that as their timekeeping source. This one doesn't though. You see, this one has your regular bog standard 32.768 kilohertz crystal. It's a quartz movement. It is not using mains frequency at all. In fact, most of those alarm clocks run on AC. This runs on DC. So it has a very simple power supply. It's converting AC straight to DC with no clock going through. So it has its own crystal. Now, granted, those 80s alarm clocks, while true, when they lost power, they didn't tick because there was no movement from the timekeeping because the battery wasn't powering any crystal because there was nothing in there. It just stored the last known time. Good for like power outages. This one does tick. So I don't know, maybe that's what they mean by automatic time. Either way, the box seems to make you believe that it's atomic when it's really not. Anyway, with those 2 points made, it's not so far that bad of a clock, considering its price, which we're talking really dirt cheap, like a DVD movie costs more than this. Let's talk about the real deal breaker here, the display. The display on this clock is so unbelievably bright. The dimmer says high and low. But let me tell you something. The dimmer's real settings are bright, and holy crap, it's brighter than the moon. I'm not kidding here. So, I wish I was kidding, because when I first set this up, when it was on bright, I was like, oh my god, I can read a novel with this thing. It makes a good book light on the other side of the room. Put it on low, close my eyes, and I still see some light going through my eyes. This is annoying, like really, really bad. Now, if you look closely here, the display has a slight tint. That's a modification I'm gonna tell you about that makes this alarm clock go from useless to holy crap, I want one now. Let's talk about it. So, back in the 70s, a company named Sperry made a gas discharge display, and it had a very soft, pleasing amber colored display. The problem is it ran on like 200 volts, was not power efficient. Then the company tried to say that LEDs were nothing more than a passing phase and would basically not exist. Except that's not quite true. LEDs, as we all know, basically took over, and no one's heard of using these gas discharge displays anymore. Well, here's the problem. Those gas displays were actually very nice to look at. It had a very soft amber-colored display, and the numbers weren't super, super sharp like LEDs were. It was soft looking. Well, what if I told you, you can make this clock emulate a Sperry gas discharge display with nothing more than something you probably have already in your house? A piece of yellow envelope, or orange, whatever color this really is. This is all you need. Just cut it out into the shape of the display, sandwich it between the window inside and the display, which is why it has that little color to it, and suddenly you have a really, really good emulation of a Sperry gas display. And I'm not even kidding. Just look at this display. From the time I power it on, it looks fantastic. I mean, wow. Really, wow. Even in a dark bedroom, the display has such a nice ambient glow. And that color is so pleasing to the eye. When your eyes are closed, you don't see the light even at the brightest setting. And it does not illuminate the room. On the brightest setting, it illuminates it just barely. We're talking darker than even the moon itself, but enough that you can get up and go to the bathroom in an otherwise completely pitch black room without tripping on anything, but at the same time not annoying you. And because it's thick, light doesn't normally go through it, that's why it's darkening the display, while also giving it a color. And because of that thickness, it diffuses the light from the LEDs just slightly, that it makes it look soft. Now, yes, it doesn't look entirely like one of those gas discharge displays. The segments don't look quite right. It still looks like an LED, but nobody said you couldn't technically make those gas discharge displays look like an LED. So, if you were to set this up, and I'm someone who has used equipment that have one of those old gas discharge displays, when I did this mod, not even thinking that I was going to make it look like anything particular, when I turned it on, I was like, holy crap, that looks like a Sperry. Anyway, YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this review and a very simple modification to it. It's a very cheap alarm clock. Yes, even with the mod, it still has some... It still has at least one flaw, which is the timekeeping accuracy. While yes, quartz movements are very accurate, after a few months it may be off just a little bit. This one drifted, I want to say maybe 30 seconds in the period of 3 months. So it's not really that bad. It's not a big deal. this is something you do with a wristwatch, usually anyway. So just get it knowing that it's not really automatic timekeeping. There's no atomic functionality on it whatsoever. Just know that Sharp lied, or didn't really so much as lie. They just made you believe it was something else when it really wasn't. But anyway, enjoy.